Thank you. We are going to start the show in just a couple of minutes, but we want to see how many people we can actually bring into the theater with some no-shows. So what I'd love you to do is just move towards the center of your aisle, if you would, so that people could fill in on the outside. You don't have to climb over you. And then we can get a sense of how many people we can actually bring in that bought tickets to watch this show in the lobby. That's how popular it was. Thank you so much. So just shift a little bit. We'll get a count for seats. We'll bring in the last few people, and we'll start in just a few minutes. Thank you. Everybody in the theater! This is so camp-like, it is scary how camp-like this is. There were towels all over the whole front center before we even opened the doors. That's how scary this is. So welcome everybody, welcome. My name is Scott Gelfand. I have been at Berkeley Tuolumne Camp since 1986 as the recreation director, then the assistant director, and then the writer and producer along with Steve Geary of the show since 1986. It is my honor and privilege, believe you me. I wanted to start with just a couple of housekeeping things, let you know the schedule, and then some thanks, and then I'll turn it over to Steve, and then I'll come back and finish with the prep for the show. So in terms of housekeeping, there are four exits here. One exit, two exit, three exit, and a fourth exit up there. Okay, so those where the exits are. And we ask that please turn off your cell phones, because unlike Camp Tuolumne, the cell phones actually work here. So if you take a moment, turn off your cell phones, that would be great. We also want to thank you so much. There was such a great demand for tickets for this event. And of course, we could only sort of publicize it through the Friends page, which was the central voice for camp. So for those people that didn't get in, we want them to know we are going to tape the event. We are going to put it up on YouTube so they can see it as well. So thank you. In terms of thank yous, I want to start off by thanking the Berkeley Repertory Theater. They were more than gracious about this. They were excited to host this. So Susie Medic, who is a Camp Tuolumne parent, and also is one of the people who runs the theater here, one of the main people, they were incredibly excited to have this day happen here. So the staff have been wonderful all day today, and we thank them in the booth, we thank them in the house. Thank you so much for hosting us today. I want to thank Lisa Bowinkle, whose business is called Another Bowinkle Show. She is the Hoopla CEO of the East Bay. Lisa co-produced this event with me, and it is truly another Bowinkle Show to have this happen at the Berkeley Rep. She spent countless hours. She's also a Berkeley Tuolumne parent, an artist in residence, and has a child who went through staff. So thank you, Lisa, so much for all your hard work. Great job. I'd like to thank the camps office in the city of Berkeley, who have been extraordinarily helpful in being communicative and also keeping our hopes and dreams alive. And so we have some city of Berkeley people here. We'd like them to stand up. Give them a huge round of applause. It is a great feeling as the people who have been going to camp to know that the people that are in charge really want this to succeed. And so I think everybody in the community feels really grateful to have the city behind them as well. I want to thank the East Bay Media Center, who made DVD copies for free of the staff shows that we've been doing since I've been doing the shows and taping them since 1986. So we have about 16 years that the copies were good enough to tape. And those are on sale. The Friends of Berkeley Tuolumne Camp have a table outside. There's great t-shirts. There's shows you can take home and have a little bit of camp with you. And please visit their store. There's some beautiful artwork there for sale as well. So go ahead and visit the store when the show is over. That's a good place to donate and also take something home with you. So a big round of applause to the Friends of Berkeley Camp. And as you know, the costumes and sets all burned down for the show, of course. Every year we spend lots of time doing costumes and sets over work weekend, but there are superheroes in the crowd today. So our costume designers, Leslie Weir and Margie Messick, who've done our costumes for years, came to the rescue along with a small company called Amazon, and they recreated the staff superhero costumes for today. Give them a big round of applause. Of course, you know we build elaborate sets at camp, very expensive, very highly technical sets at camp. And we didn't have those, so we turned to our set designers who were at Work Weekend this year, Mark and Carol, who are artists and builders and have the most extraordinary talents in the world. And in a very short window of time, I like to say one day, they recreated the two most important sets that we needed for a show to make it somewhat realistic. So get Carol and Mark, who are here, a huge round of applause. I mentioned the Friends of Berkeley Camp, and Steve's going to talk about it a little bit as a board member. What I want to say about them is, from my heart, they have now become a central voice for us as a community. And so we need a central voice. And so please go to their website. I'm sure Steve will elaborate a little bit about this. But I want to say that I really appreciate how long they've been carrying the candle for the voice of camp, for fundraising, for advocating for camp. They're a very important organization. Let's give them their support. A huge round of applause. So we have some donations, a lot of donations, and I just want to touch on a couple. They are very special. Donkey and Goat Winery donated all that delicious wine that's in the lobby. On your program, there are a bunch of companies that gave us sweets and other things, but Lane Splitter Pizza, who are near and dear to my heart, they're a great company. They donated pizza for after the show, so huge round of applause. And now I'd like to turn it over to one of my dearest human beings on the planet. He co-writes the shows with me, he co-directs, he actually takes over the shows, really. And we need that because he's better at it than I. Put your hands together, give a huge warm welcome for Steve Geary.
Moment up here. I've had such a treat working with Scott on the show for the last 15 years or so. I've been on staff started about 20 years ago as well, and just have a wonderful affiliation with camp, and it's really near and dear to my heart. And as I've gotten a little older in my role, I've been lucky to have that sort of expanded to two Tuolumne Ranger hats, if you will. One is continuing to work on the show, and the other is as a board member for the Friends of Berkeley Camp. And so I'm here today representing the Friends and to say to all of you, well, Scott said it nicer, of course, than I ever could, so thank you, Scott. But wanted to just mention that the Friends is a really powerful organization, been around for about 30 years, supporting camp in its times of need, and that has obviously evolved over the years. And I wanted to let you all know that we, as board members and as a Friends organization, really recognize that due to recent events, I think the Friends organization really is going to be evolving and continuing to move along and really going to be there to serve camp in its needs going forward. So I really encourage all of you to join us. It's free. Right now, we just want everyone, we want a place where people can feel like they can get information about camp, they can share their love and enthusiasm. We're using it as a place where we'll be able to announce other events like this, look for volunteer and for help from all of you at times. So if you haven't, please go to FOBTC.com, sign up on there, and just really looking forward to continuing to be that conduit voice between this amazing camper community and in the city of Berkeley and camp. So thanks, and a little more from Scott, and I promise we're
getting... Can you give us an update of what's going on?
I think actually the Facebook page is probably the best place to look for information right now, and the city as well is doing a great job of publishing some information out there as right, you know, as it's sort of evolving. You know, the as I know, as you all do, right, it's a pretty huge and sort of tragic event, and the city has jumped right in there. I'm incredibly impressed with how quickly they've gotten people in there and are already kind of working to stabilize things and, you know, just start the cleanup effort right away. It's incredible. it's really, stuff's going on right away, right now, faster than I ever thought it would be happening. So that's all I'm going to say for now.
All right, so I'm going to give you a little bit of the speech that we give at the first rehearsal of the show, which is, you are a great audience. You are here to laugh, to sing, to be enthusiastic audience members to a fabulous bunch of actors who did not sign up to be actors. But it is part of their job. They love doing it. In fact, I like to say that the intersection of these staff shows is the unending enthusiasm and energy from the staff, meeting the unending appreciation from the campers. And that's where we meet. These guys have left camp, you know, really traumatized, like we all have, but they were at the property. And some of them have left things behind that were never recovered. They went off to schools, they went off to colleges. They have come back at great length to be here for this one day. And some of them will be going home quickly after the show as well, because they start school tomorrow. Ushers have come in who are former staff to do the same from colleges that are far away. So what I'd love to say is the reason we're here is because we as a community have been hurt. We've all been hurt by this. We've all been touched by this and have felt it deeply in our hearts. And the reason we created this today, Lisa and I and Steve, was to have a little bit of laughter, remind us of our camp spirit, what really connects us. Is that intersection, that camp spirit where our enthusiasm meets unending enthusiasm from the staff. These guys did one rehearsal today just like they do at camp. They don't even remember their lines when they're there during the summer. So your job today is to applaud wildly at every chance you get. Thank you so much for being here. Enjoy the show.
Special presentation of the 2013 Camp Tuolumne staff show, Captain Amazing and the Superheroes of Tuolumne. Tonight's exciting adventure of superheroes, villains, clones, and takeovers begins like so many other adventures at the Berkeley Main Library, where two friends are catching up on homework and other reading.
Man, this math homework is so tough. She just pours it on us, doesn't she?
Yeah. I find math to be so... Whoa. No way. Exciting.
What are you talking about? Nice math book, Captain Amazing and the Superheroes of Tuolumne? What comics are those?
The BTC comics, the original, before Marvel and DC comics, is where all the great superheroes got their start. Really good stuff.
But why don't I know about BTC comics? And which superheroes are we talking about?
What do you mean, which ones? They're all in here. All the great ones are trained at Tuolumne. Dude, where have you been?
Doing my math homework, obviously. But wait, all of them?
All the best. Superman! Tio.
Wow. Captain Amazing, the original superhero. He's off the charts. But I really don't understand why he's standing like that.
Oh, she's just pausing until we finish. It's for a dramatic effect.
Huh. That's really cool. I never thought about superheroes at Tuolumne, but I guess it makes sense though. That place seems to be teeming with superhuman talent. I mean, they're so good looking. Just how do they do it?
Okay, they get it. You're amazing. Let's get back to the show.
Okay, so what happens in this one?
It's epic. So it's at a Berkeley Tuolumne camp, our superhero staff summertime hangout when they're not saving lives back in the bay. BTC is the most popular family camp in the world. People plan their whole summer around their trip to camp. And when they get there, it's like this whole other world. Anyway, camp has been a success for more than 90 years. And sometimes success draws the attention of some unsavory characters. But don't let me spoil it for you. Read on.
But what about math?
Math? It's summertime. This doesn't make any sense. Who writes this stuff?
I don't know.
Come on, let's read.
Amazing. And you're here with me at my favorite place in the whole world, Berkeley Tuolumne Camp. Is that the best? The best ever, with the tall trees and the warm sunny days and cobbler for dessert and more. In fact, it's true, I'm under its spell. Excited, I want to yell. At camp, I'm feeling so swell. And that is making your favorite dish, turkey or maybe spit. Actually, you just make a wish. Today is just that day. Please see the road. Love keeps growing. No show, no time to slow.
Incorporated, a multi-conglomerate international company who are looking for a new business venture. First up, the president of the board, Dr. Evil.
Oh no!
Yes, yes, Well, let's find out where they are. Catwoman!
Family camp, after all. Then they can go and find out all of its secrets, figure out what makes it work, steal them.
We can use it to build our own camps.
Ooh!
You are good! Yeah. All right. I like that. All right! All those in favor, raise your hand! One, two, three, read out. Good enough for me, though!
I didn't even need a countdown. You knew we could do that.
All right, all right. Well then, minute you pack your bags, because we're off to camp!
Yeah!
Yeah, that's right. Because you know, here at Eva Lee, it's all about the love of money. Cut off. 40! She's 40. She just looks very
Wait! Choose! Minnie!
Okay. You won't let them choose. It'll be assignment only.
Yes.
That's the evil thing to do.
Yes.
Well, all right, Wonder Woman. Don't worry.
You haven't seen the last of Oz.
Thank you.
bit pricey, if you ask me. And our cab will automate it all. Machines everywhere. Vending machines, that is. And then they'll have to bring their credit cards because it makes more money. So make sure they bring their credit cards.
Working at Camp Tuolumne, and I'm gonna sing about it.
here, Captain. It is the sausage! The rusty old bed frames!
No, no, come on! I'm gonna try it here.
Is it the staff? Oh, I mean, of course! It's the staff!
Don't know what kind of peril they're in.
Right? I was reading ahead a bit. Instead of finding ways to defeat Dr. Evil, it looks like a few staffers are finding new feelings for each other.
Watch out, there's heat in the D hall.
I am Chef really knows how to bring out that perfect flavor of dino nuggets. Oh no, my sugar shaker's a little low. Anyone around to bring some sugar? Anyone?
Oh. I'll give you some sugars. There's nothing that campers enjoy more than a full box of sugar.
Whew, is it just me or is it getting a little hotter in here?
Nothing like a little spicy, which are sweet. Especially on make your own burrito day.
My
been sending someone over there to all of you before anyone even noticed.
Ready? Let's make some socks.
Had to do clothes. Oh, had. Oh, had. Oh, had. Had amazing machine. Knew just what it would do. Make me evil copies. I just didn't know who. I'm not trying to be funny, so you better not grow. I'm just here to tell y'all that I had to do clothes. Had to do clothes. Do it. I'm in good company. Monsanto's my neighbor. I'm a sheep named Ali. Now it's your turn, Staffers. Yours and yours alone. I'm just here to tell y'all that I had to do clothes.
Yeah.
Sometimes I stay up counting my blessings, grateful to talk at my home. But now I fear the camp is going under, a secret evil plot unknown.
Yeah.
Dr. Evil and Mini-Me.
I'm here to save you all.
My, my, look what the cat dragged in.
Well, well, Captain Amazing, guess who the boss was looking for?
Oh my god, is that a metal belt? It's a shame those ties didn't come with suspenders.
Thank you.
Hammer of the Gods.
Yeah.
ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for our narrators. Our random camper cameos. The robot clones. Going for our other superheroes, starting with Elastigirl in the T-Hall. And Tapatio. In maintenance, we have Thor the Mighty Dog. We have Batman and Spider-Man. And in the kitchen, let's give it up for Iron Chef. And in the office, put your hands together for Wonder Woman and Superman. And of course, this wouldn't be complete without Evil Incorporated, the Joker, Magneto, and Catwoman. And of course, Dr. Evil and Mini-Me. And finally, your very own Captain Amazing. Don't forget about our crew in backstage and our costumes. Don't forget about us up here in Lights and Sound. And a big thank you from the crew of the Berkeley Repertory Theater. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the casting crew of the 2013 Camp Tuolumne Staff Show. We now invite all of the children in the audience to join us on stage for the singing of the camp song.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's give one more round of applause for our whole cast and crew.